There was recently a very minor change to the studio setup window in Cubase, and in this quick tip video, we're going to take a look. Let's go to the studio menu and then go down to the studio setup control panel. And here on the left-hand side, we can see the audio system. So this is where we select our audio device and driver. So if you can't see your driver there, you need to go back and make sure you've installed it properly. I'm using a Steinberg UR44, so I'm going to select that. Now, in the actual driver section, I can see all of my inputs and all of my outputs listed there, and I can also go into my device control panel, and that's where I can change the buffer size. A higher buffer size gives me latency, meaning there's delay from when I sing to what I'm hearing in my ears. A lower buffer size will mean it's more of a direct sound, which is better for recording. A larger buffer size would be better for, say, mixing when you don't need to record anything and you just need that little bit of extra CPU power and RAM. This control panel is really the control panel for devices that we have connected or devices that we're going to use to control different things inside of Cubase. So for instance, I can select MIDI inputs for the chord track and I can see the MIDI devices that I have connected to Cubase and a number of other things which we don't need to worry about just yet. Let's hit OK, and now our settings are complete. One final thing is to check your audio connections. So in my input section, I can see my audio device, and I can see that my inputs are input 1 and input 2, which is basically the left and the right stereo input. Now the stereo outputs are also set to the left and right, and I don't need to worry about any of those other things on the right-hand side. Now, when I add an audio track, I can see that input listed there. And I set that up in the audio connections and ensured that was correct. If I'm recording a microphone, it's going to be a mono track. So I'm just giving it a name and selecting add track. Now when I go over to the left-hand side, I can see my input and my output routing is correct and it's connected. And you're set to record audio and hear what's going on inside of Cubase. Thanks for taking the time to stop by and check out this quick tip video. Subscribe to the Cubase channel and give us the thumbs up if you've learned something. See you soon.